What we like to recommend folks do, what teachers do, is to think about the four E's. Is the technology equitable? Does that particular technology promote more equitable opportunities for students without adding additional barriers? Is it more efficient? Does it save time, save energy, save other resources? Is it more effective? Does the technology make learning more effective for all of the students or some of the students? Mm-hmm. And is it engaging?
Hello there, and welcome to today's episode of the Easy EdTech Podcast. My name is Monica Burns, and I am so glad that you're here to join me today. If you want to make the most of education technology, aka EdTech, well, you are in the right place. My goal has always been to help make EdTech easier and give you ideas you can try yourself, share with a colleague, or bookmark for later in the school year. Every Tuesday here on the Easy EdTech Podcast, you'll hear stories from my time in the classroom, the work I do now with schools and districts, and my travels to different EdTech events. Get ready for solo episodes where I share some quick tips and stories, and interviews full of practical ideas and stories from new guests each month. If we mention something you'd like to check out, make sure to click the link. You'll find it in the episode description or the summary area where you're listening to this podcast, or you can find every episode and all of the resources we mention by going to classtechtips.com/podcast. Or by going to classtechtips.com and just clicking on the Easy EdTech podcast button at the top of the page. This episode is sponsored by the blog at classtechtips.com. If you're looking for wintertime activities or ways to make connections between the season and what you're teaching, then head over to the blog page of classtechtips.com. You'll find a search bar where you can type in keywords like winter, Thanksgiving, or bulletin board ideas. You name it. So head over to classtechtips.com/blog and use the search bar to find over 1,000 blog posts and podcast episodes full of ideas to try. This week's episode is titled Tech Savvy Approaches for a Differentiated Classroom with Dr. Clare Kilbane and Dr. Natalie Milman. They are fellow ASCD authors and have a new book titled Using Technology in a Differentiated Classroom. So for today's episode, they joined me to chat about the EdTech connection to their work. Let's jump into the conversation. Welcome to the podcast. I'm so excited today to chat about some tech-savvy approaches for a differentiated classroom and your new book from ASCD. But before we get into all of that, would love to hear a bit about your role in education. Maybe Clare, we can start with you. What does your day-to-day look like?
Sure. So I currently work at the University of Notre Dame, which is in Indiana, and I'm a professor of the practice there and connected to an institute. So there I work with graduate students who are future teachers. And then I also design curriculum materials and professional development for in-service teachers. A lot of the work I do actually focuses on teachers in Catholic schools right now.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. And Natalie, would love to hear a bit about your day-to-day as well.
Yeah, I'm Natalie Milman. I am Associate Dean of the Office of Student Life at GW's Graduate School of Education and Human Development. And I'm also a professor of educational technology in a 100% master's program. And I'm also an advisor and teach in a human technology collaboration PhD program. As an administrator in my day-to-day life, I oversee admissions, marketing, and our student success, so student supports. My teaching load has been diminished because of my administrative responsibilities, but I've been at GW since 2001 and have a great deal of online teaching experience in the field of educational technology.
Well, you both see a lot, I'm sure, in your day-to-day, right? Hearing stories from different people in different roles, the folks you work with directly and the people that might come back to you, right? To share some
problems of practice or some areas, you know, of concern that they're working on in their school and district community. And, you know, today we're talking about differentiation, which is the focus of your new book with ASCD. You know, Natalie, what are some common misconceptions about differentiation?
I believe that one of the biggest and most common misconceptions is that teachers often feel like they have to do every single aspect of differentiation simultaneously. Mm-hmm. So this idea that you're differentiating content, process, and product all at the same time, for example, and that's not the intention. The intention is that teachers are approaching design very, very thoughtfully, approaching how they differentiate for the diverse learners' needs. And it might just be content, or it might just be process, or it might just be product or environment for that matter.
Yeah. And that's, I think, something that's really wonderful for someone to hear who's kind of tackled this topic before, has thought about what it might look like in their learning environment, and maybe felt a bit overwhelmed trying to do all the things, like you just said, that might not be a reasonable ask for us to, right, ask anyone to do all at the same time. So, Clare, how do you see the role of technology evolving in supporting differentiation in classrooms today?
Thanks for that great question. So I guess the first thing I'd say is that we have a lot more technology in schools today than we might have had 10 years ago. Mm-hmm. The emphasis in the past was really trying to get enough tools. And now I think one of the challenges is figuring out how to use them well. The reality is that we have so many things and not enough time to think about using them properly. Mm-hmm. So I guess I think that technology has evolved in terms of the amount, but it's also become more powerful and more diversified. So it really helps to get your brain wrapped around what technology is and how it can function for you. Natalie and I like to use the term digital tools when we talk about technology, because when we use the term technology, you kind of lump it all in together and we don't distinguish that each technology is different, you know. So if we think about them as tools, first off, we're thinking about them in service of what we want to achieve, and rather than something that's running us. But we also begin to think about how they might be different. You know, we look at a workbench, we see a hammer, we see a screwdriver, we see some tools that are multi-purpose, and the technologies are like that too. So I think it's important for teachers to think about what the tools are and then how they want to use them. So I guess one thing I've seen that's really kind of interesting in the classroom is that we have just this variety of tools that we can use. We have administrative tools that we might use for grading and communications. We have operational tools that we could use, like learning management systems, to help us kind of keep organized. And then we have this vast array of pedagogical tools, and all of those different types of tools can help in a differentiation effort.
I love those categories and just the visual that you shared, right? You know, that you might walk into someone's garage, right, and see, you know, these different kinds of, right, or these different types of tools. And the categories that you shared are ones that I think people could probably name what those tools might be for them, right? Like, what is their LMS, or what is the tool that helps them stay, you know, organized or on task? And then what are those tools that are definitely student facing, right, that might help them, right, access material or help them, you know, wrap their head around something brand new that just has those additional features, right, that makes that digital tool, right, that piece of technology so special. So can you explain what it means to approach differentiation as an educational designer? How can educators adopt that mindset?
I think most of us are familiar with this idea of a designer. If we watch cable television, or I guess stream television now, we see a lot of design shows. And I think design is so prescient, or so important today, because it's needed to really make full advantage of the wonderful resources that we have available to us. You know, it used to be about trying to get enough resources, you know, trying to survive, and now it's about trying to thrive. And thriving really is using your resources well. So I think the design mindset's really appropriate for teachers today. And a designer further is, as I guess if we had to define it, a designer would be someone who creates solutions and experiences for other people. So the other person is really at the center of a designer's work, and teachers have always been about serving their students. And so I guess I think that bringing together this idea of design with the contemporary classroom today is a really great thing, because it helps a teacher kind of approach their work with greater intentionality and clear focus on their goals. And then they can borrow from some of the great strategic thinking and other types of resources that designers use. So they can use strategies to develop clear goals. They can approach the use of their tools and their skills with greater intentionality and purpose. And so that's really, I think, what Natalie and I are talking about when we talk about thinking about being an educational designer. Natalie, would you add anything?
One thing that I can add is in an article that was published in 2023, where we talked about the importance of having that mindset of being an educational designer, but the fact that teachers need to be very purposeful about it. So that, you know, like, what are the goals? What are the objectives? What are they trying to achieve vis-a-vis differentiation? And again, that idea of you get what you design for. Mm-hmm. And while there are many standards and other requirements that teachers have to meet across, you know, all the different varied content areas, grade levels, school districts, even so, they have the power and the knowledge and the professionalism to design their students' learning experiences.
Yeah. And just, you know, that idea of you get what you design for, I think really comes back to the words that you both said about purpose, about intention. When you are crafting, right, an experience for students, it has to be really intentional. And I love both of the examples that you gave and the framing there, because I do think it's something that, you know, some people might do without really naming or thinking about with that same level of attention, but, you know, you get what you design for, just like you said, Natalie. So what digital tools or platforms do you find most effective for differentiating content, process, and product?
That's an excellent question. And what we like to recommend folks do, what teachers do, is to think about the four E's. Is the technology equitable? Does that particular technology promote more equitable opportunities for students without adding additional barriers? Is it more efficient? Does it save time, save energy, save other resources? Is it more effective? Does the technology make learning more effective for all of the students or some of the students? Mm-hmm. And is it engaging? Does the technology stimulate students' attention and motivation? So, you know, we like for teachers to think about these questions, because we believe that if they can answer those that it can lead them to figuring out which tools are more effective for differentiating content, process, and product.
I love that for just making sure that people have some vocabulary, you know, for the conversations they're having with their colleagues. They might come together and say, this, not that, or, you know, is this really addressing this other piece that we've placed value on? So I think that vocabulary is great for anyone who's listening right now and is coaching, you know, a group, is leading a group in conversation, maybe acting as a mentor, or even just reflecting on their own, you know, professional choices, right? Having that language, I think, could be really helpful. So Clare, how can teachers ensure that the technology they choose is not only engaging, but also equitable for their students?
Well, technology is pretty attention grabbing and interesting, right? We could incorporate it in even the most bland lesson, and it would make it a little bit more interesting for some students, maybe allow them to pay attention more, maybe feel like the learning is more valid and worth their time. So it can be tempting to integrate technology for that pure reason of the engagement. But I think teachers need to resist having just that one reason, because it's not always going to help all learners. We kind of go back to that idea of tools. Any tool that we use has an effect on us. The tool itself might be neutral, right? and it might need us to give it meaning in how we use it. But even having a tool has an impact. So just imagine you can have a hammer, and even without using it, the fact that you're holding it keeps you from fully using your hand. So the tools aren't really neutral when we need to think carefully about how they're going to affect us. And so I think that's really important when we look at the tools we incorporate in our classroom. They're not the same. Some are more complex and some are more simple. Some are going to require other skills and knowledge to be utilized, and some will not. And likewise, some students will have a greater affinity or proclivity to use certain tools than other tools. And so as we make the selection of the tools, we want to make sure they're matched with the right task and can be effectively used for it. But we also want to be paying attention to how it might disadvantage some students, if that makes sense. And I think we want to invite students to be thoughtful users of tools that allows them to be able to function more fully in their life outside of school. But it also allows the teacher to get some support in mitigating the effects of the tools. You know, when the student's empowered to say, hey, you know, this tool isn't a good choice for me, I'm going to do this low tech, or this particular tool might allow me to get this work done more powerfully. So we really want to invite them, and that, you know, not only empowers them, but also makes it easier for the teacher to get it right.
Yeah, and just building that community where students feel comfortable, where they feel like their voice is valued, right, as part of that conversation is huge, because as you mentioned, it can be really easy to find something engaging or bright and shiny, but it doesn't mean that it accomplishes, you know, all the other goals that you might have.
And so, And I just like to add that when we devised the four E's, the first question we purposefully chose for it to focus on the use of technology being equitable. Because first and foremost, you know, we want to ensure that all of the students have access to it, that they're able to use it, and all the other questions that we have associated with what might be equitable. What might be equitable for one may not be equitable for another. So then is it really a tool that we should use?
And just that idea that you're kind of coming into that conversation with that leading the way is a great reminder for someone who might be looking at a list, right, or making a decision what they're going to bring back to a group. So, you know, Natalie, what advice do you have for teachers who are brand new to using technology for differentiation? Is there kind of one thing they could try out tomorrow?
I often think of one of the easiest ways to differentiate is to differentiate the product. So, you know, but before understanding how to differentiate product, it's just important to understand what differentiation means and how it can be achieved. And also, again, understanding you don't have to differentiate content, process, and product based on students' interests, readiness, and learning profile, or content, process, product, and environment based on interest, readiness, and learning profile. Like, you know, we can't do it all the time. But thinking about, like, well, where might I be able to differentiate and for whom? Product is great because it allows students to demonstrate their capabilities in different ways. It gives students the opportunity to be creative. They can use different technology tools in achieving kind of the same results. And it also gives them the opportunity to engage in choice, which is one of the hallmarks of differentiated instruction.
Yeah, such great advice for someone who's kind of tackling this for the first time, or for the first time in a long time, or alongside, you know, some of the technology and digital tools that they might have access to this year. So your new book, Using Technology in a Differentiated Classroom, is now available from ASCD. Would love to hear where people can connect with you both. You know, where can they learn more about your work and your new book?
Well, we'll both be at the ASCD ISTD conferences that will be occurring during summer 2025. And so that's one great place. The book is obviously another great way to get connected to our work. We have a Twitter handle, which is Designed to Diff, and they can connect with us there. And Natalie, would you add some other ways?
Yeah, I'm available on LinkedIn. I don't post that often, but I do post occasionally, sometimes X, previously known as Twitter.
Yeah, I still call it Twitter, I think, most of the time. I don't know if I'm ever going to get over that hump until there's some like new tool that comes in that maybe has a similar name, right? Or something like that. Well, this has just been so wonderful. I'm going to link out to the article that you mentioned, where people can find you both on social, to the new book, but really appreciate you both for carving out some time and sharing some actionable tips with listeners.
It's been a pleasure. Thanks for the opportunity.
Yeah, thank you.
This was such a great conversation, so let's finish up like we always do with a few key points from this episode. Differentiation doesn't require addressing every element. View digital tools as individual resources rather than grouping all technology together. Approach differentiation with a design mindset. And the four E's, equitable, efficient, effective, and engaging, provide a framework for evaluating the use of technology in differentiated instruction. Remember, you can find the show notes and the full list of resources from today's episode, including all of the ways to connect with Natalie and Claire, by heading to classtechtips.com/podcast and finding today's episode number 296. This episode is sponsored by the blog at classtechtips.com. If you're looking for wintertime activities or ways to make connections between the season and what you're teaching, then head over to the blog page of classtechtips.com. You'll find a search bar where you can type in keywords like winter, Thanksgiving, or bulletin board ideas. You name it. So head over to classtechtips.com/blog and use the search bar to find over 1,000 blog posts and podcast episodes full of ideas to try. Thank you for listening to this new episode of the Easy EdTech Podcast. I love creating new episodes for you each week, but I could use a bit of help spreading the word about the podcast. Can you leave a rating or review on your favorite podcast app? Spotify will let you tap on the stars, and Apple Podcasts will let you tap on the stars and leave a 1 or 2 sentence review. Thank you so much for taking this extra step. It helps other educators find episodes like this one when they're searching for EdTech tips.